Okay, so what we're gonna do now, the first thing we're gonna do, we're gonna put everything in stack views. After that, we're gonna test the UI. And after that, we're actually gonna add some small shadows to the button so that we have like this really small blue glow. Okay? Okay, so stack views. When we use stack views, stack views have like an horizontal orientation and a vertical orientation. And what this means, when you put elements inside a stack view, the stack view can stack them horizontally or vertically. It's a really easy way of building UIs that actually scale from smaller devices to big devices. That is why we are talking about it, and that's why we are using it in our UI, in our storyboard today. So how this works, let's open up this one. Okay, so we already created the stack view here, right? That's the text. So now we have this one and we have this one. So first we're gonna select these two, and no, not that one, this one. So we're gonna select username, we're gonna select the first text field, and we're gonna select the small line under there. And we're actually gonna put these in the stack view. Perfect. Okay. So for the other one, we're gonna do the same. This one, and this one. We're also gonna put that one into a stack view. Oh, wrong one. Stack view. Perfect. We're gonna put this one in the stack view. So the forget your button, forget your password button. We're gonna put this button also in the stack view. Perfect. And last but not least, we're gonna put this one in the stack view. And last but not least, we're gonna select all of these. And yes, we're also gonna put this one into a stack view. When working with stack views, you can use so many stack views as you want. You can also put a stack view inside a stack view, inside a stack view, and so on and so on. Doesn't matter. I won't recommend it because it's really hard to build UIs like that when you work with too much stack views. But in this case, it's actually, for me, it's, I think it's good practice to work with multiple stack views inside. So first, we're gonna give the head stack view, so the main stack view, we're gonna give them constraints. So we're gonna constrain this, maybe 20, 20, and we're gonna constrain it 20 from the top, and let's take a 20 from the bottom. Perfect. Okay. So we're gonna open the first stack view, that's this one. So we're gonna constrain this one, 0 from the left, and 0 from the top. Perfect. Then we're gonna select the second one. And the second one we also gonna put, in this case, 0, 0. So we're gonna do 0, 0. And we're gonna open the stack view. We're gonna click username. And we're gonna constrain the username, 0 from the top, 0 from the left. And the rounded thingy, we're gonna do 0 and 0 from the left and 6 from the top. Okay. And I think it's good practice if we give these fields, if we give them some extra constraints later. So we're gonna select the view under there. We're gonna give this a 0, 0 from the left and a 6 from the top. Perfect. So after that, we're gonna click on the next stack view. And this stack view, we also gonna put 0 from the left, 0 from the right. Perfect. Then we're gonna click on password. Password is also gonna be 0 from the left, 0 from the top. Perfect. Then we're gonna select the rounded thing here. We're gonna do that 0 and 0. And I'm not sure if we gave this one. Did we give this one constraints from the top? Let's check that out. Yes, we did. 6. So we're gonna do with this one, we're gonna do the same. We're gonna give this 6 from the top. Perfect. So this stack view, we actually want to put this one on the left. So we're going to do the 40 from the top, and we're going to do this 0 from the right. Oh, wait a second, they're on the red instead. And we're also going to do 0 from the left. And then we're going to click this one, the text. And the text alignment, we're going to constrain this one, 0 from the left and 0 from the right. Oh, this is a button. Yeah, of course. And we're going to give this button a fixed width and a fixed height. So we're going to give the height of 28, and we're going to give this maybe a fixed width of 100. Let's see what happens. Comment C. Okay, so we're going to click this stack view. And in here we can actually decide how we want to fill it. So we want to trail it. So perfect. And trailing, that means right, and then we have the other one leading is on the left. Okay. And as you can see, this it's like a lot of space here, right? So let's select this stack view. Let's go in here. Let's see if we can change the this one. I'm going to change this to 20. And I think we don't need this one. Perfect. Okay. So let's select the main stack view, so on top. And now we're actually going to play with some stuff here. So in this case, we want it to center. We want it to fill equally. Perfect. Okay. So we're going to select this one. We're going to give it an alignment of left. And we don't give it... First, let's give it the placeholder text. So the placeholder is going to be... No, we don't need a placeholder because we already have the thingy there. Okay. With this one, we're going to do the same. Alignment left and no borders. Okay. And then we have this button here. So this button, we're going to give this a 0 from the left, 0 from the right. Perfect. Then we're going to take the stack view. The stack view is also going to be 0 from the left, 0 from the right. So 0, 0, 40 from the top is okay. Perfect. Then we have the last button. We're also going to give this one. We're not going to constrain this one. We're just going to give the stack view 0 and 0 and 40 from the top. Perfect. And the button is already centered, but to be sure, we're going to give the alignment here. We're going to give it the center because this way we make sure that the button stays in the middle. So let's test this out on the simulator. And let's see how this looks. Okay, this looks actually not that great. I'm not happy with this yet. Okay, that one works. This one works as well. And as you can see, we don't have the line here, right? This line over here, we forgot to align it. So this view here, let's give this a 0 and a 0. Perfect. Let's start it again. Okay, now it is there. Okay, so we still have to work on the button, right? So let's look at the button and let's see what kind of constraints that one has. It has only trailing and... Okay, so we want this to be a fixed height and we want a height of 40. So let's give this a fixed height of 40. Let's run this again. That is not 40. Let's make this... 35. The button, right? Button is 35. Perfect. No. Okay, let's delete this one. The top constraint. We don't need that one anymore. Okay. So this is curious. Okay, so first let's change the text color, or let's change the text to login. Let's change the font. So first we're gonna go to bold. We're gonna click custom, and after that we go to Futura. Let's check this out. And the text color is gonna be white. Let's run this. Okay, so now we have like this really big phone and a really big button. Let's try this again. Okay, so the button. What is the height at this moment? Now we're gonna select the button. Where's the button? The login button. Let's check the height. Okay, so as you can see, the height here is still 51, and it shouldn't be 51. So let's check the stack view. Okay, so theoretically the button should be 35. So let's see. Let's see if we, 51 minus 35. So 16, so 8. So we're gonna do 8 from the bottom, 8 from the top. Let's run this, let's see if this works. I'm not sure. Okay, so I figured it out. When we select the stack view here, so the main stack view, and instead of fill equally, we're gonna do equal centering. The reason why, and that is something with stack views, it can be really difficult sometimes. And the reason why it doesn't adopt like the constraint is because the main constraint, so the main, is always telling other ones like, hey, you have to be this big. And when you give this one a constraint, it's not gonna listen because it has to adopt the constraint of the parent. So let's go back here. And we're actually gonna change the constraint here, and we're gonna change this to 45. Let's run this one more time. Let's see how this looks. Yeah, this looks a lot better. So even when we click something in here. Okay. One more tip. It's good practice when you add in a past for password field. It's really good practice when you click on secure entry. So let's see. here, secure text entry. And this means that when you put in a password, nobody actually sees what you're typing. You only see the dots, right? So it's always good practice to put that one in place. And yeah, only thing I still have to do is some shadow on the button. So let's go to our view controller. Okay. So what we can do login button dot layer dot shadow opacity is equal 1. There we do login button dot layer dot shadow offset is equal to CG size dot 0. There we have login button dot layer dot shadow color is equal to, and we're actually gonna use the same color as we have here, so we can just copy and paste this color. And last but not least, we're gonna do dot layer dot shadow radius is equal to 2.0. Let's run this and let's check how this looks. Okay, so as you can see, you don't see it very well, but now we have like this really small shadow around the button. And this is actually what you always need for a shadow in UI Kit. So, first I want to clean up our code, because as you can see, we did actually copy paste, and when you code, you don't do copy paste. So what you can do above here, var color equals your color, and then we can actually delete these ones, and we can just call color. With this one, we can do the same, color. Let's run this again, just to make sure. Okay, pretty cool. We actually created a really nice UI. This truly looks amazing. I have to say, it looks actually really nice. But let's go to the main.storyboard and let's see how this looks when we put this on like an iPhone. I think this is an iPhone 11. So this is how it looks on the iPhone 11 Pro Max. As you can see, you just see you get more space between elements. And this is a little bit how this works, right? It looks really, really beautiful. So, this is going to be the end of this video. I want to congratulate you on actually finishing your first real UI. I hope you guys understand how this works. To be honest, working with stack views, it can be really complicated. But it's actually a really good way of designing a UI. And if you don't understand it, make sure to come into Discord. I'm always there to help you. Would it happen that you, after this course, you're going to build your own application and you still need help? Hit us up on Discord. Me and my moderators, we are happy to help you with everything that you need. And I see you in the next video.